During the Christmas season, no place is more magical than the forest of soon-to-be Christmas trees. You see, just as the branches of the trees grow, so does their holiday cheer. When they are fully grown, their Christmas cheer can be felt by all who wander near them. That night, some of the older trees were telling the youngest about the process of becoming a Christmas tree.
"You'll get to travel far away from the forest," said one tree.
"And be decorated with beautiful ornaments," said another.
"Then on Christmas morning, the family will open presents all around you.
And everyone will be joyful and full of Christmas cheer."
"This all sounds so exciting," said the youngest tree. "I can't wait to become a Christmas tree."
But this was not the truth, for the little tree was actually quite scared of becoming a Christmas tree.
"I don't want to be taken far away from the forest," thought the youngest tree. "What if my family thinks I'm too small to be decorated? They would throw me out. And what if there are no presents to open on Christmas morning? There will be no cheer at all."
The youngest tree was so scared that he couldn't sleep through the night. The next day, a small family came into the forest and began looking at the trees.
"This could be it," said one tree.
"Oh, I hope they pick me," said another.
"Please don't pick me," thought the youngest tree.
A little girl ran up to the youngest tree and pointed.
"This one! I want this one! It's the perfect tree!"
"Oh no," thought the youngest tree. "This is terrible."
And so the family chopped the youngest tree down and fastened it to the top of the car to drive home. As the car moved farther and farther away from the forest, the youngest tree's fear grew and grew. The tree could hear its friends calling from the forest.
"Congratulations!
I'm so happy for you.
Make sure to spread Christmas cheer."
The family eventually made it back to their home, where they took the youngest tree and placed it inside their house. When the tree saw the house, its fear got even worse.
"There are no decorations," thought the tree. "Just four empty walls. This is nothing like the forest."
The tree looked down.
"And no presents? This is awful. There isn't any cheer here."
The young tree became so sad that it began to cry. After a while, the little girl walked into the room with the rest of her family. The tree saw that she was holding a single red ornament. The little girl walked right up to the tree and hung the ornament.
"We don't have a lot of expensive decorations," said the little girl, "but I wanted to make sure you looked like a proper Christmas tree."
Then the little girl's parents set a small present under the tree.
"We couldn't buy a lot of expensive presents," said the father of the little girl, "but we wanted to make sure you got to celebrate Christmas."
"Now you better be off to bed," said the mother of the little girl. "You can open your present tomorrow, on Christmas Day."
And so the family went to bed, leaving the young tree alone with the ornament and the present. And for the first time, the tree was no longer scared.
"Being a Christmas tree isn't about getting decorated," said the tree, "or having presents all around you. Being a Christmas tree is about spreading cheer to those who need it."
The young tree could feel its Christmas spirit growing and moving all through the house. The four empty walls of the room seemed brighter and more cheerful. The present beneath the tree seemed perfectly placed, and the single ornament on the tree began to shine as if it were brand new. The next morning, the family celebrated around the Christmas tree. Everyone was joyful and full of cheer.
"Merry Christmas."
"I love you."
"Thank you so much."
The young Christmas tree looked out the window and saw another tree in the house next door. This tree was from the same forest as the young tree.
"Merry Christmas," said the tree. "You look like you're spreading a lot of Christmas cheer."
And then the young Christmas tree realized that even though it wasn't in the forest, it was still connected to it. The cheer from the forest came with the young tree, and now the tree's family was using it as well. And that day, no place was more magical than the young Christmas tree's small house, which had a small family with a lot of Christmas cheer.